Good evening. The Minister for the Environment has said people refusing to pay their water charges won't be cut off or have their pressure on their supply reduced. But speaking in Cork this evening, Helen Kelly insisted Irish Water will pursue people for money owed.
Wherever ministers go, protesters follow. Albeit a token picket today, they want the government to know they're not going away. 450 people are fielding calls from homeowners who have a wide range of questions they want answered. On a visit to Cork today, Minister for the Environment answered the burning question, will people who don't pay their water charges have their supply reduced or cut off?
Being realistic, I don't think it's appropriate to be using the language of going out and saying you're going to potentially cut off people or reduce their pressure of their water. I probably don't think it was helpful day one, and maybe it wasn't the approach that should have been taken. In fact, I would say it wasn't the approach that should have been taken.
So is it fair to say that their water will not be cut off?
Well, it's never the ambition to cut off anyone's water. I would say that out straight. And the government are looking at other mechanisms.
Abtran, the company awarded the contract to handle queries on behalf of Irish Water, have so far had 474,000 contacts. Irish Water is confident people will come around to paying for their water.
If you look at all of the different the property tax, the household charge, all of the different charges that were introduced in recent years, the vast majority of Irish people paid those charges. Indeed, in the property tax, it's over 90%.
Despite a guarantee that pressure won't be reduced, protesters still want to see an end to Irish Water.
There's been a lot of concessions made already. The government are on their own. They're nearly ready, fit to break up at this stage. No, we're keeping the pressure on. The only concession we're accepting is the end of Irish Water and the end of the charges. Nothing else.
Minister Kelly said he has no problem with people marching on the streets, but said some of the demonstrations have been sinister. Don't go there and don't get me started. Some of the things people say when they hear the words Irish Water. By his own admission, company boss John Tierney said mistakes have been made in recent months and that he's working closely with the government to address issues of concern. But while they tried to sort out what some say has been a PR disaster from day one, there appears to be no let-up in the number of angry people strongly opposed to paying for their water. Paul Byrne, The 5:30 Cork.
Well, earlier the Taoiseach and Thánaiste presented a united front over the controversy. They deny there are divisions within the coalition over how the problem is being confronted.
Their backbenchers are getting edgy. Huge crowds are protesting on the streets. Headlines proclaim chaos at Cabinet. But you'd never guess any of this from looking at the Taoiseach and Thánaiste. Behind the scenes, the two are locked in tense negotiations to sort out the Irish Water fiasco. They claim they're making progress.
Taoiseach, how strained now are relations between yourself and Joan Burton following her solo run on Irish Water? She did take you by surprise.
Let me assure you, Ursula, that the relationship between the Thánaiste and the Taoiseach is very strong, is really focused on the job we have to do, and I share the view expressed by the Thánaiste that we should have the contributions from householders as affordable, as fair and as low as possible.
So, Ursula, what do you want me to say? Do you want I think the relationship is a very strong, positive working relationship. Yes, there have been huge difficulties in relation to Irish Water. It's a very ambitious public utility.
But behind the show of unity, hints of trouble appear. Both leaders retreated to waffle when asked a direct question.
So Irish Water isn't going to sink this government?
The people will elect the next government in the spring of 2016. And the fundamental question that people will be asked is, did this government fulfil the mandate that it was given? And that mandate was to fix our public finances and to put our people back to work.
So could Irish Water sink this government?
I think that when we have finalised the arrangements that we've been discussing, as I said, I think we will have a situation where the charges will be fair, there will be clarity about the charges, there will be certainty about the charges.
I'm just not hearing a lot of confidence that Irish Water won't sink this government.
Well, at the end of the day, as the Taoiseach said, it's for the people to make their choice in the election.
Significantly, neither chose to dismiss the possibility of Irish Water bringing down the government. Today, they presented an image of unity, but they provided little hard evidence of an agreed formula to fix the problem. The next 10 days are going to be crucial. Ursula Halligan, The 5:30.